Hello everybody, this is Weetabix and I think that these chocolate melts bar Weetabix are just Weetabix's version of the Kellogg's Crave. Anyway, it says it's fortified with vitamins and iron. Don't say which vitamins. No, it says it's fortified with iron, which is actually quite good because we all need more iron in our lives. Yes, we do. And what else is it? It's high in fibre! And it's low in salt. And it's whole grain. It's voted product of the year, but you know what? You can ignore all this because companies pay for this. You'll actually find there's probably about five different kinds of cereals, maybe more, product of the year. Because this will be the best cereal that's got chocolate in the middle or something stupid. What's it? You've got to read the back for these things. It's a bit of a. It's not a scam, but it's not what you might think it is. I hate all this product of the year rubbish. Anyway, a crunchy whole grain and high in fibre shell with a smooth milk chocolate filled centre. For a morning kickstart, for an afternoon snacking, or for evening nibbling, with an exclamation mark. There is pictures at the end so you can see what's not in them and what is in them. You may have noticed that this box is already open. That's because my nephew was raved into it. Look how he's opened the box. Look at the state of that. Vandalism. I've not tried either of these. He asked if you could have some of these. I said, of course you can. Whenever I've done a review, I've never stopped anyone eating my review stuff, even before. I said, I can always rebuy it. I got them both from Aldi. I've completely forgotten to find the receipt to know how much there was. But who cares, you know what I mean? If you find them at a price that you might think is good enough, then buy them. And if not, then don't. And it's completely up to you, and it might be completely on how you see this review. You might think this review is great and it tastes amazing, then that'll be more of an inclination for you to buy them yourself, isn't it? These are also not a product promotion or anything like that. I don't know anybody who works at Weetabix or for Weetabix or is affiliated with Weetabix. And yes, I bought them from Aldi, but the same goes with that. This is not a paid for promotion or anything like that. There's absolutely nowt to do with me other than me paying out my own cash buying these to review because cereal is expensive. Look how thin this box is, and this is meant to be 12 servings. Really? I think my nephew has had about allegedly three servings. How much is. See what I mean? The boxes have gone already. Anyway, let's see what they're like. I'm gonna try this one. This is the milk chocolate one. They don't have a more wheaty taste than the Kellogg's Crave, actually. They're bigger. But if I bite them in half, there's a little bit of air in there. They're not completely chocolate filled. Does the picture allude to the fact that it's completely chocolate filled? Yeah. Winner cereal category, it says, of 9,897 people by Kantar. All right then, whatever. Yeah, they're all right. Not massively sweet though. We'll put some of them in a bowl, and we'll see how they absorb the milk. I'm going to put in a few in. I'm not scoffing a load because I cooked for my mum and my nephew today for the first time ever. And they really enjoyed it, which is nice. Let's move on to the white chocolate melts. Oh, you'll take a lay down then, by why don't you? You take a sleep a bix. Oh, I'm a comedian. Look! This is an informational video for my nephew. This is how you open these kinds of boxes. And look! Look! Now you can reseal it! Amazing! Anyway. Yeah, the boxes are quite underfilled anyway. This may actually be what is expected of you of a serving. Ridiculous, isn't it? Right, the white chocolate ones are new, it says. There's no exclamation mark, so it's not new. It's just new, which is great. These are also fortified with vitamins and iron. Not a promotion by Tefal. Tefal. How do you pronounce it? There will be a picture at the end so you can see what's in it and what's not in it. It's the same stuff written on the back, but these ones are white chocolate, allegedly. And are they actually chocolate? Not particularly well filled, are they? I mean, that one's hardly got anything in at all. No, there's not a lot of chocolate in these, is there? And you know what? Not getting much of a taste either. Right. Let me get... Oh, you took a sleep as well. You took a Nappabix. And you know what? I always seem to set my camera up right where the knife and fork drawer is. Not really a over-the-top fan of cereals myself. Anyway. Not because I dislike them or anything like that. I just find them so expensive for what they are. I don't see why the boxes have to be so small. After a couple of minutes, they seem to have absorbed a bit of water. Milk. Look. I'm using whole milk. Yeah. With the milk, it has created a bit of a moment. They might hit the roof of your mouth, actually. If you were to pour out a sensible bowl of these, which is probably like the whole bag, into the bowl, you might find that they might hit the roof of your mouth a bit. They're very sharp. Very rough, rather. Not very sweet. Something like this, back in the day, would have been so sweet. There'd have been loads of sugar in. And by reducing sugar, it just makes me want to add sugar. Let's try these ones in a bowl. Adding the milk. A bit more milk in. See if that'll help it. I'll let the milk sink in for a bit. No, they're not that impressive, actually. There's the amount of chocolate in the centre is not very centred because it's a small amount, so it's slumped to the bottom. Oh, what's this? Oh, it's the crumbs. We're going to see. It's the crumbs from the box. Stupid box and crumbs everywhere. Anyway. Not that great. I'm going to have to search for the receipt now to see how much these was. Let me in the comment section down below if you've tried them or if you're going to try them. They're not horrible, but if... I tell you what, I'm going to find the receipt, then I'll decide whether these was a waste of cash or not. Hang on. After rummaging around, I found the receipt. It looks as if there was £1.99 each. Melts milk chocolate and Melts white chocolate, it says there. £1.99 each. The A and B thing is something to do with tax code. So I think if it's got an A or a B, it's whether it's taxed or not. Anyway, fun information. At £2 each, I still found these quite expensive. Because cereal is expensive, isn't it? And they don't taste that amazing. They're all right. Anyway, pictures at the end so you can see what's in them and what is not in them. Thanks for watching. Scrubs. Bye.